I'm the regional services officer from Wentworth Prison. I rang through earlier this morning. Is it all right if I see Lynn?
Yes.
Hi. I spoke to your doctor, Lynn. He's worried about you. Seems to think that you don't want to help yourself. I told him that you're full of self-pity. Can't say that I blame you. I'd probably be feeling pretty sorry for myself, too. I mean, after all, what do you have to live for, right? Of course, you're only on remand. You haven't even been to trial yet. And there's always the possibility that you'd only have to serve a few more months. But that'd be a lifetime, wouldn't it? And what's the point in hanging around? You might as well end it all. The only thing that I'd be worried about would be hurting my parents. How do you think your parents would feel if you killed yourself, Lynn?
They'd probably be pleased.
You really think so? You think that they'd be happy to lose their only child? Do you love them? But you don't think that they love you?
How could they after what I've done?
Maybe they're shocked and disappointed, but you only feel like that because you love someone. And that doesn't stop you from loving that person.
You really believe that?
Yes. Have you written to them yet?
What would I say?
You know, it's funny. Out of most of the women that I've seen inside prison, oh, sure, there's always the odd families that turn their backs on them. But usually it's the other way around. I guess that they feel guilty and ashamed. But this is the time when they really need to keep in contact with their families. If you like, I could write to them for you. I'm sure they'll feel better if they heard from you. I've also arranged for you to see a lawyer.
Oh, what good's that gonna do? You heard what that man said?
Yes, well, he's the one who's agreed to defend you.
Well, I don't want him to.
He's one of the best barristers around, Lynn. If anyone can help you, he can.
I don't like him.
You don't have to like him. The important thing is that he's good. You've got to trust me, Lynn. I want to help you.
Why? Why would anyone want to help?
It's my job. And also, I think you deserve another chance in life.
I tried that once, remember?
So try it again. I don't think Doug would want you to throw in the towel. Do you?
Hello, Mr. Wilson.
Good afternoon, Miss Vernon.
I just talked to Lynn Warner. She's agreed to have you as a lawyer.
That's big of her.
Now, look, Mr. Wilson. Lynn's been through one hell of a lot, and the last thing that she needs is a lawyer who's going to push her around. So try to be gentle with her. I know it'll be difficult for
you. Miss Vernon, I think that I can manage to handle it.
Good.
Sorry I'm late!
Oh, may I help? I'm completely out of control in here. I'm going to throw myself out of a window at any minute.
Oh, my God.
Just stand there. This is an emergency.
What is it supposed to be?
At least I tried. I am not a housewife and I never will be a housewife. It's spaghetti.
Oh.
Next time I'll make us a sandwich.
Is it edible?
It'll be delicious if I can just get it out of the table.
Well, I'm glad none of your boyfriends are coming for dinner.
What boyfriend?
Well, Greg's face would be a study in how to be polite and Steve Wilson would be out the front door like a shot.
Steve Wilson?
Well, I have it on good authority. You're stringing them both along.
So much for your good authority. Steve Wilson is a pig.
Oh.
Intelligent, maybe even smart, occasionally human, but nevertheless a pig.
He'd love to hear you say that. Now, you better put that pot into soak.
Yeah. Coagulates completely. I didn't expect you home so late. I wasn't going to throw a meal at you as soon as you got back.
Susan Rice is back.
What?
Yeah, she was only out 5 hours or so after the hearing.
After she paid her bail?
She's back.
For stealing?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I think we've got a right one on our hands there.
Well, I don't know. As far as I'm concerned, she seems normal enough.
I disagree.
Well, what's the matter with her?
Well, don't you think she's a bit odd?
Well, not particularly. I mean, she's always been calm and quiet with me.
Well, that's just the point. One minute she's as sane as anybody else, and then the next... I think there's more to that one than meets the eye. So, you just left Sid Butterfield cold. No word of where you were going or what you were going to do. That just astounds me, Lynn. Do you realize the position you've put us in?
Look, I thought it'd be all right as long as I got back here on time.
You just didn't think. You've made it so much more difficult for any of the other girls to go on the scheme. Do you realize that? Where did you go?
I went to see Doug's grave.
Oh, heaven's sakes, Lynn. We do not normally allow convicted criminals of armed robbery to go roaming around the countryside. You were given consideration as a very special case and you've blown it.
I'm sorry.
Okay. So where do we go from here?
Well, I don't suppose they'll give me a second chance. I didn't think so.
They're giving you 1 week suspension. Mr. Butterfield's agreed to take you back. I think he may be taking some of the blame himself, but that's just between you and me, so you're lucky. But if you do it again, I'll personally wring your neck. Why didn't you go home, Susan? What's stopping you? Is it because your husband started divorce proceedings against you?
That's not true.
It is true, and you know it.
It's his work that keeps him away from home.
I don't believe you. He hasn't been living with you for the past 3 months, has he?
How are the kids?
I didn't see them.
I miss them, you know.
Then why did you do what you did yesterday? I'm going to have to contact your husband, Susan, whether you like it or not. I just thought I'd let you know.
Thank you, Jimmy.
Jimmy?
I've been here before.
Oh, you come here often with hors d'oeuvres at $8.50?
Well, if you want the best, you have to pay for it. You haven't been here before, hmm?
I know so few millionaires.
Their loss.
Do you realize that a whole family could eat for a week on the price of a main course?
My mother would have stretched that to a fortnight.
Where is she now, in the old age home?
She's dead.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Cancer. My father was a TPI. He died shortly after she did. They never owned their own house, and I never owned a suit until I was 23. I hope that qualifies me for the human race by your exacting standards.
You've come a long way.
Oh, some of it was luck. A lot of the fellows at my school were brighter than I was, but, well, they didn't quite make it. Which is why I am genuinely interested in helping people who, well, don't get an even break.
This doesn't sound like the Steve Wilson I know and hate.
You still think that I'm devious, though, hmm?
Well...
Right then, I am. I am a little devious. In fact, I'm being devious tonight. You see, I do have an ulterior motive for this meal.
Oh?
I want a little more tonight from you than just your charming conversation.
Oh?
Yes, well, you would rather than I lay it on the line, wouldn't you, than pussyfoot about.
I've always thought that honesty is the best policy.
Ah, here comes my ulterior motive now. Clara, my dear.
Oh, I'm dreadfully late. I'm so sorry,
oh,
darling.
It's lovely to see you.
You must be the clever girl who's going to help me.
Yes, Clara, I'd like you to meet Jean Vernon. Jean, this is Mrs. Goddard.
How do you do?
Hello. I'm going to what?
Oh, you tell her about it and I'll get you a drink.
Super. Well, to put it simply, I want to open a halfway house. I'm tired of working for the Heart Foundation and the Red Cross. It's boring. The real need is for the victims of the system, don't you agree? The wrecked lives, forever shattered, unless we do something about them.
You mean you want to open a halfway house for ex-prisoners?
Naturally. I think I put that perfectly clearly, didn't I, Steve?
Clarity itself.
Oh, Steve has always been a great help to me with all my little charities, you know. With his expertise and your good advice, I'm sure that we'll soon have the show on the road.
What sort of money are you planning to put into it?
What do you think? About 80,000.
80,000?
Now, you have to tell us the best way to use it.
The best way to use it would be to give it to the Salvation Army. That's where it could do the most good.
Clara would rather do it her way, Jane.
You mustn't rob me of my little pleasures, dear.
It would be far better to give it to an established organization. The Salvos perform miracles on a prayer and a crust of bread and a bacon rind. With real money, they could do so much more.
Well, I'm sorry, but I don't think religion should come into it. I don't want my girls brainwashed. I really don't.
Salvation Army is not a brainwashing organization.
Clara is entitled to spend her money anywhere she likes, Jean.
Of course, I know it's her money, but you did ask me my advice.
We do so want it, dear. We do.
Now, you really haven't heard Clara's great idea. She wants to give the girls a place they can run by themselves, for themselves.
No, that wouldn't work.
Why?
The law prefers that old acquaintance be forgot. The girls aren't capable of it. They just couldn't cope.
Oh, some of them could. Karen Travers, for instance. Well, she would hardly call her inadequate. She's intelligent, capable, and reliable. Why, Karen could run the whole thing.
Karen. I see.
Intelligent, capable, and reliable. Tell me, darling, what is this Paragon doing in jail?
Yes, all right. I'll see you then. Good, thank you. Bye-bye.
I just thought you might like to know that Lynn Warner slashed her wrist yesterday. She's in a very bad way.
Really?
Yes, really. Is that all you've got to say?
What do you want me to say?
I hope you realize that it's our fault.
What do you mean it's our fault?
I blame myself as much as I do you.
Oh, well, that's really very big of you.
Don't be so bloody cynical.
I'm not being cynical. I just don't know what you're talking about. All I did was give the girl some advice.
Oh, yes, good old legal advice. You might as well have whacked her over the head with a law book. You were so damn superior. You couldn't have cared less.
This is a legal practice, Miss Vernon, not a Lonely Hearts Club. I gave the girl the facts.
Yeah, the facts. Why didn't you give her a little thing called hope? That's the most important thing to these women. Sometimes it's the only thing that they have to hang on to. You don't have to be a genius to see that.
Oh, no, just a Jean Vernon, eh?
Very funny. No, I blew it too. I should have realized what she was going through. But I was too busy with other things.
Yes. Well, I happen to be rather busy myself. So, if you'll excuse me.
I forgot, time is money, right? I hope Karen Travers makes it worth your while.
Oh, I'll do my job, Miss Vernon. You do yours.
Is that advice free?
If it makes you feel better, I'll send you an account.
Don't tell me you need the money.
Problems?
Oh, not if you're a duck, I suppose. I'm going to have to move from that wretched place before I get washed away. And I've invited Greg to dinner. I hope he's got webbed feet.
Well, I'm sure he won't mind if you put him off.
It's all very vague anyway. Hey, listen, I owe you a dinner too. Well, why don't we make it a threesome? Just as soon as I beat my agent in producing a plumber, all the water just naturally seeps down to the flat below. Do you want something?
No. I heard you were looking for me.
No. Oh, yeah. It's about the searching every time I come into prison. Oh, how much longer is it going to go on for? It's driving me mad.
Well, we're being searched, too. I mean, everything's been tightened up.
Yeah, well, I know it's necessary. Sometimes it's quite embarrassing.